Sodium-ion batteries have the potential to be lower cost, theoretically safer, and more versatile than current lithium-ion batteries. They could help diversify the supply chain and also improve the sustainability of battery production.
Two of the key advantages of sodium-ion batteries are cost and safety. This comes from the raw materials that are used in sodium-ion batteries, broadly moving away from nickel and cobalt and towards abundant materials like manganese and iron. Those materials are used in the cathode, but as we look towards current collectors, also substituting the copper out for aluminium, which can be used on both sides, can have serious implications on the cost and safety of the batteries during transport.
The battery chemistry has already drawn the attention of the world's largest automakers, from BYD to Stellantis, and the largest battery producers such as CATL and Northvolt. In China, China's largest EV maker, BYD, has started construction on a 30 gigawatt hour sodium ion battery factory in the country. Yet their energy density is currently lower than lithium ion batteries, making it challenging for use in electric vehicles. It will also take time to scale up their production. So, is their technology ready for the fast lane? The electrochemical reaction of a sodium ion battery is similar to that of a lithium ion battery. Where sodium ion batteries differ is the type of iron being used. Sodium ions are about 3 times heavier and 4 times larger than lithium ions, which impacts the energy density of the batteries.
The state-of-the-art sodium-ion batteries today do have a lower energy density than lithium-ion batteries. If you look at state-of-the-art chemistries, they sit at around 160 watt-hours per kilo. Comparing that to something like LFP battery cells that sit around 200 watt-hours per kilo, that's a 25% increase that's needed to come from cell design and manufacturing alone, and really that's quite a big ask. When you look at the higher end of lithium-ion battery cell performance towards your high nickel NCM chemistries, you're talking 260 watt hours per kilo at a minimum, and bridging that gap is really tough to do without serious innovation in materials chemistry.
Sodium-ion cathode materials can be broadly divided into 3 classes: layered oxide, polyanionic, and Prussian blue-white analogues. Many of these cathodes contain high manganese or iron content, both of which have robust existing supply chains. Swedish startup Altris says its Prussian white cathode is the simplest technology because it mostly contains iron.
Our Prussian white is the most sustainable, I would say, in terms of cathode material. It contains sodium, iron, carbon and nitrogen, and nothing more.
Sodium-ion batteries rely on sodium, which is sourced from soda ash, a globally abundant resource. They also substitute the graphite for different carbon materials such as hard carbon. But the supply chain needs to be scaled up, especially for the anode.
Over the past few years, we've seen some really impressive announcements by companies both in China and in the rest of the world with respect to sodium ion cell capacity. Total pipeline capacity now exceeds 300 gigawatt hours, and building an industry of that size requires some serious evolution of supply chains. Hard carbon is the state-of-the-art anode material that's been benchmarked for a lot of these chemistries, and the capacity that we're seeing being developed at the moment means this material could become a real bottleneck.
Sodium-ion batteries may be safer due to the compatibility of some anodes with less flammable solvents, making them suitable for energy storage and electric two-wheeler applications.
We have the sustainability, lower carbon footprint. You have the cost, lower cost compared to lithium ion, and you have the safety aspects as well. Less risk of a fire or thermal runaways compared to lithium ion. Plus one more thing, you can store the batteries at 0 volt, which means you can have longer storage, no problems with transportation, and this in the same way when you're assembling, for instance, your energy storage container solution, the operators can feel safer because there is no energy left because they are fully discharged.
Still, commercializing new battery technology takes time, and sodium-ion batteries are only at the beginning of their development. Benchmark is tracking a total of 44 planned sodium-ion battery production plants with a potential capacity of over 300 gigawatt hours as part of its monthly sodium-ion market assessment. Please contact us to find out more about services we offer in the sodium-ion battery market.